Falcons. I just made a play in the red zone, going strong. Watch me shake and bake.
Let's go.
I just took off with that rock, just like Tyreek Hill. I just count 100 racks, that's a whole field. He don't want no championship, get him out of here. I just got a sack, like I run up in the backfield. I just got a sack, like I ran up on a quarterback. Shake and bake, make a play just like a quarterback. We ain't worrying about no formers, we ain't staying there. Running off the block, yeah, I'm something like a linebacker. I got juice like a Fanta, how you like it?
How you like it?
I'm on purple, I'm on yellow, like a Viking.
Like a Viking.
All these plays that I'm catching, I done gone crazy. I do my thing, six range, just like Tom Brady. Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped the bag on the tag, ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunning.
The NFL on EA Sports is in the great state of Tennessee at Nissan Stadium here in Nashville. This crowd here fired up for football as a moment ago their Titans were introduced. This should be a good one as the Titans get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Here's the punter Bradley Pinion on to get us started. And off we go from Nashville. This one fielded at the five. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line.
The Titans take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. Now a first carry for Derrick Henry. And he stopped it. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense, and know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
They don't know my name, I get through the pain, taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains, I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go, but I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yo, look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come and call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs. In a town you create where there ain't no love.
Where do I go?
Reflux, I drip out from the socket to a teacup. Drink up inside, look when they peep us. Jesus in the belly of the beast, but outside there's a war going on your front lawn. Black Hawks see the red dawn horizon. Blind yet I'm rising, abiding by laws of attraction. My thoughts still rising, thinking. What type of knowledge don't sink in? Life gives you lemons, and my only thought is drinking. Thirsty, will I be alive or dead before 30? That's all that concerns me early. Lemonade quenching my inner rage when it takes center stage, way before they pouring on my grave. Minute made, let it set my soul ablaze on each and every way. Put me in the water for the save.
They don't know my name.
The NFL on EA Sports is in the great state of Tennessee at Nissan Stadium here in Nashville.
Mm-hmm.
around me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drill, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. I can't hear the hate, got a lot of it. Take these bands to the bank, let them rot in it. So much ice on me, I wish I had two necks. I got homies that can sleep without two. I got homies that can sleep without. Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Gon' pop it for me, cause I'm rich and poppin' in. Yeah, drill. Little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drill. Little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me though. Cha-cha macho with a rockin' black clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, duckin' 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, little bro. Let me feel myself.
The NFL on EA Sports is in the great state of Tennessee at Nissan Stadium here in Nashville. This crowd here fired up for football as a moment ago their Titans were introduced. This should be a good one as the Titans get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
He's set to kick off.
The Titans kicker Steven Gostkowski ready to do the honors, and we are underway in Nashville. Taken at the 15, a short kick. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it.
Complete.
17 yards on the game's opening play, and a quick first down. And a big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Here's Brady. They're going for Howard, but the pass intercepted. Picked off near the 42. 20, 10. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And the defense could not have written a much better script than that. First drive, pick six.
The offense never got a chance to really get oiled up there, did they? But the defense, they certainly got in gear. What a big-time play and a great way for them to start.
And now the offense, they've got to turn things around and figure this out because your backs are on the ground real quickly.
Yeah, usually when you're starting the game getting the ball, 0-0 is the only score you're worried about. Now the second time you get it, you're already down a touchdown.
And this will make it into the end zone. Oh, a good return up past the 30. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line.
At their own 35-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Here's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
At the 33-yard line.
Of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Shotgun now for Brady. Open man, Gronkowski complete. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
For a tight end, he's got good straight line speed. And on that route, he's often the guy that gets overlooked. Nice job there finding him in stride for really good yardage.
Now carry there for Fournette as he's able to work his way for a gain of about 5.
He was Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Back to the ground, this time with Jones. And he is going to get this close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the Titans 39. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
Buccaneers.
Brady now on first down. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. The catch and run there, good for 16 in the first.
First down, Tampa Bay.
Brady gives this one off to Jones. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
On second and nine, Brady. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far and brings up third down.
And 9 yards.
Now play number seven of this drive, but it's a tough third and nine. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Going for Evans, but that pass is intercepted. Picked off by the USC man, Adoree Jackson. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
On the ground, this is Derrick Henry. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here.
The ball carrier.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. From the gun, here's Tannehill. And that is incomplete.
And that's exactly what defense is talking about. You've got to find ways to get off the field when you can, especially on third down. And third down defense going to be vital in this game. Able to knock that one away and force a fourth down.
On is Kern, the punter, to send this one away. Not good at all. Punt of just 24 yards there. And possession will switch hands, first and 10.
30-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three.
I know you got ghetto.
from the gun, it's Brady. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
An 8-yard pickup. And the Buccaneer first down.
Operating from the gun, Brady. That's complete to his receiver, Godwin. Brady. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
To throw again on second down, Brady. The left side completion to Jones. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
But they certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
They'll run on first down. It's Jones. And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about three down to the 38.
Tackle made.
But from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. But let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. 3 3-yard gains. That means they're punting the ball likely on
four. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Picked up by the USC man, Adoree Jackson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
The Titans take over first and 10 at their own 12-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Henry. And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. Carlton Davis.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. Gun, Tannehill. He finds Corey Davis. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A gain of 13. It's a first down. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone.
A trying for Humphreys, but it's intercepted. Picked off near the 26. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
pressure here, and down he goes. Sack back at about the 43-yard line. And their inaugural sack of the game coming from an unlikely source.
You mean it wasn't a linebacker? It wasn't a defensive end?
It was somebody like you.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, that's a surprise for the offense. That's not what they normally get when they think about pressure.
On third down, Jones. And he can only manage to get this to the 45-yard line. Well short of the first. It's a gain of just three, and the offense likely going to yield to the punting unit here on fourth down. And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five. They do go for it. It's Brady. Open man is Godwin. It's complete. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That's a fourth down pickup of 10 yards and an opportunity certainly missed on the defensive side. On first down, Jones. And he'll be brought down at about the 42.
The ball carrier.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Well, they don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. On second down, it's Jones. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first.
A gain of four.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. Looking for Godwin, and he's got him complete. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Nice third down conversion and even 20 yards.
First down.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Into the red zone, it's Brady. Incomplete. The running back, Leonard Fournette, his intended receiver. But it'll be second down.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. Harold Landry in there to drop him for a loss on the play.
Third down. Third and
so Brady and the Bucs need to work a little magic. Third and long after that last sack. From the gun, Brady. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more.
Brady. I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, Parker, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting three? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find one to get you into the end zone, get you six?
The Titans take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. You're under a minute to go here in the half. Field position not really in your favor, but still time to try and move the ball and get in field goal range.
Yeah, you've got the lead. It's definitely a thought. Let's go ahead and try and increase it. But at the same time, I don't like the odds. I don't like where they are on the field. They've got the lead. They've done well in the first half. Don't mess it up. And going to halftime, looking at each other, wondering what if.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. to throw. Tannehill into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr.
Certainly feels like the classic second guess, but let's be honest about it. They had a chance going to halftime with the lead. Why did they take a chance with a throw there? I don't understand that.
Well, that's what I'm wondering, and now this defense has to try to protect that lead going into the locker room. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. So after the INT, it's Brady. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 25. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Intercepted. The Titans take over first and 10.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now a timeout taken. He was perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see.
Second and 12 at the 20-yard line.
The opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Tannehill, he's going deep for Brown. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Tannehill. Carlton Davis picks it. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
At their own 35-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
So we've reached intermission here in a low-scoring game. 7-3 is our score. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? That'll be taken about a yard deep. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23.
The Titans take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Tannehill and the Titans come up now first and 10 at their own 23. He'll start with a give to Henry. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
I'd say it's pretty good strategy. If you throw interceptions on back-to-back drives, let's see if the running backs can handle the ball a little bit, get things going. And also, you motivate your offensive line. I think they're in the mood to fire out and hit someone.
I thought the defense, though, might be a little more prepared for that run. Pretty good gain on the ground. Again, it's Henry. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now Tannehill. It's caught on the right side at Smith. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run.
It doesn't look like this defense found the magic elixir at halftime. This offense was rolling in the first half, and that's continued here in the third quarter. Another big play right there.
A first down carry for Henry. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
They'll keep it on the ground. Henry.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
From the gun on third down, Tannehill. He finds Humphreys. And he will have a Titans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Running from the gun with Henry. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
On second and nine, Tannehill. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Give him seven on the play, and that'll make it third down. Carry now for Derrick Henry. Yeah, Henry fighting for the marker, but I don't think he got there. He did not. He needed two, he got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down of the yard.
Brings up fourth down and one.
Fourth down, here's Steven Goskowski for the Tennessee field goal. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And this is no good. Close, but he misses just left of the upright. And this score will stay right where it is. Well, close game, second half. You obviously hate to leave three out on the field.
Especially in a game like this when you know points are hard to come by. That was one of their best opportunities so far, and they come away with nothing.
Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a first and 10 at the 20. And he'll throw right away. He sets up the screen to Jones. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of three.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
On second down, it's Jones. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 7 yards there and a first down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy. Let him pick up the first down.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Operating from the gun, Brady. And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 35. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game.
Makes the score Titans 14. Buccaneers 3.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
First and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Thank you. The Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. And Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. Throwing again on second down. Brady, and he finds Gronk. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. The gun, Brady. He completes this into the hands of Miller. And he'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up
facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Again, it's Brady. He'll find Miller. That's complete. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. Boy, how good has this defense been seemingly all game long?
I really think right from the first snap, I think you're really onto something there. In this passing game, it just can't get off the ground. And that play, it wound up losing yardage.
Throwing is Brady on third down. Over the middle, he finds Godwin complete. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. The Bucs passing game looking good on this drive. It's a first down. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. Going deep this time for Miller. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Scotty Miller, 39 yards. And the Bucs have made this a one-score game. All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. Now Brady again. And he will get into the end zone as a two-point conversion is successful. And the lead is down to a field goal here in the fourth.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for
Tampa. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Taken in at the 3. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19.
The Titans take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. Oh, he got possession on him and he pulls it in. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
Well, how about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England, and they ended up giving it up.
I was going to say, don't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching Atlanta, our apologies.
They'll run on first down. It's Henry. He'll take this from the 40 up to the 45 for a gain of 5. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. They'll keep it on the ground. Henry. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, they didn't accomplish their goal. They didn't get a stop there, gave up another first down. They have all three timeouts in their pocket. I think defensively, you've got to start thinking about using them here.
I was just going to ask you, at what point you think now's the go time?
I think now's the go time. I don't think you sit back and wait, because they can take a lot of time off the clock between plays and run 3 to 4 and really put you in a stressful spot.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 49-yard line. Tannehill going to turn and give this to Henry. And some room to work. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. That one 28 yards on the ground.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
First down, it's Henry. A gain of 3, second down. Able to stay in bounds, and the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover, because one more score, and this game's over.
Second down, here's Henry. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is 3rd and long. Now Tannehill. And incomplete, almost intercepted. Had a great shot of picking that off in the end zone. And now 4th down.
Results. Well, when you've got a tight end who can run, you've got to give him a shot to unlock the defense. Want to see what they can get, taking the big shot downfield. That one winds up incomplete.
And Gostkowski, that's no good. He hung it out to the right. He missed it. And this score will stay right where it is. Maybe an important 4th quarter miss as this stays a 3-point game.
Yeah, now overtime is very much in the equation here. Just what you mentioned, a 3-point game. They get a drive, put it through the post. We could have some free football, couldn't we?
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
15. First down, Tampa Bay.
So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And this is going to be a Bucs first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
Partner, they're clearly saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
Buccaneer first down.
They'll look to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 38. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line.
And that one? Oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the 2-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
They'll try and choose some clock with Henry, and they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts, as they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. 45, 45. Mike, 45. Derrick Henry. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Titans. Derrick Henry, 39 yards. yards. And the interception by the Titans D leads to a touchdown. The point after try for Gostkowski. And his guys will take a 10-point lead.
Makes the score Titans 21, Buccaneers.
Gostkowski now after the touchdown. He'll send this one away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Intercepted, and that should do it.
Picked off by the safety, Kenny Vaccaro. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
Brady's
the number seven, usually lucky here. Not for him. Seven picks he's thrown in this game. That's only happened six times since 1960.
And I know that the most recent time it happened, the guy who threw him, he won a Heisman Trophy in college, so sometimes you just have a lousy game. Doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad career. But when you're talking about one game, seven, you're right, not lucky at all.
Yeah, Ty Detmer, the last to do it in 2001 to throw seven picks.
First and
they show run with three tight ends here on first down. Now it's Henry. A measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Taken down.
It was JPP that time. Jason Pierre-Paul who got in there to blow that play up. Got to figure the rush is going to be fierce again as they come up second and 13. The 20th carry now for Derrick Henry. And he'll get this down only to the 18. 1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave him with a third and 11.
A gain of a yard makes it third and 11. Today's final score, Titans.
So this one, a Tennessee Titan victory, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing three turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of... But now, it's about taking the ball away. Taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had three takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Titans are winners here as we say so long from Nashville.